It was a ceremony that saw thousands of mourners line at the entry to Karagwe Church of Uganda Cathedral to bid farewell to the country's first Deputy Prime Minister and Minister for East African Community Affairs, Right Honorable Brigadier Eria Kategaya, fondly known to his people as an honest and brave gentle politician. If the intensity of the mourning was meant to be a message to the outside world, so too was the designed parade of brigadiers that accompanied Kategaya's hearse. The square in front of the cathedral was filled with mourners, among them Kategaya's childhood friend, also chief mourner, President Yoweri Museveni, and First Lady Janet Museveni. Others included the Deputy Speaker of Parliament Jacob Olanya, Yala Speaker Margaret Ziwa, Prime Minister Mama Mbabazi, former FDC President Kano retired Dr. Kizza Besigye, former East African Community Secretary General Amanya Mshega, ministers and dignitaries from various government departments and countries. Museveni, who promised to kickstart a technical institute in the names of Eria Kategaya in Ntungamo district, described his former friend as a humble politician.
Even if you disagreed, you would not have painted and endless disagreements. I disagreed with him twice in the last 40 years. One time when we disagreed was 1973. But at some stage, we linked up again and worked very closely. Because we are not petty. I'm not petty. I don't disagree with anybody for anything which is on the way forward. If you say we go right and I say we go left, you don't convince me, I don't convince you, you go your way, I go my way. That does not stop us from linking up in future. I proposed to the Ntungamo district to get a technical school to look at the possibility of building a technical school, and we call it Eria Kategaya Memorial Technical School.
He served in government for a long time, but was never involved in stealing or scandals. He was a team builder and believed in winning people over rather than name calling, shifting blame, clip formation, backstabbing, or undermining police. He never suffered from political sclerosis.
Because he was a dependable pillar in our area, in our district, and we will miss him very, very dearly.
Kategaya's family members could not hold their tears.
We miss Daddy. He told us to be firm. He told us to be strong, always. And we're going to carry that out.
He was given an 11-gun military salute as his coffin was gently laid into his final resting place. Kategaya, who died of a blood clot in Nairobi Hospital, has had a modest political career in a span of 3 decades. He has been hailed by many as a down-to-earth politician whose great deeds and virtue will be missed. Moses Walgembe, UBC News, Itojo, Ntungamo.